What are the ethics of our time? What are the boundaries of acceptable behavior? And not just in business or in politics, but personally, what is? And this film was willing to engage that in a, I thought, a really smart, dramatic way.
I know you're not going to get a more authentic film about Wall Street than this film. I mean, these are based on many real events, real characters, and the real places that they go to.
There's a $400 million hole here. I mean, that can't be right.
He makes a decision to invest in a situation that, if it works, makes everyone a fortune. He bends the rules to make this bet.
When they call
money in there until they sign.
You're looking at 1,000 years jail time.
What am I supposed to do?
And for the moment, he's losing the bet.
There's an accident that happens that kind of turns his world upside down. He has to not only deal now with this money problem, but he kind of has blood on his hands and has to deal with that also.
We've been blessed with a very gifted troupe of actors who've gone as far as a performer can go to deliver an authentic performance.
Richard Gere plays Robert Miller, who's a very wealthy man who lives in a beautiful mansion in Gramercy Park.
How much money do we need? Do you want to be the richest guy in the cemetery?
I don't want to be in the cemetery.
It's a very, very, very wealthy world, this stuff.
Tim Roth is such a talent that he's been around for also for a long time, has an amazing body of work himself.
We had a scene yesterday, and we had quite a bit of sparring to do back and forth, and it was fun.
Where'd you go?
Home.
You're straight home?
Yeah.
You stayed home?
Yeah.
Your wife home?
Yes. It's a very, I think, a subtle scene of interrogation. You are a little confused by all this, aren't you?
I am, but I get there. Give me time.
And the tension between those two points of view, I think, make for the audience a fun kind of scene to watch.
One of the things I really like about Arbitrage is the casting of the women around Richard Gere. It's interesting to have Susan Sarandon play his wife.
We've known each other forever. I think this is the second time we've played husband and wife.
Everything I do is for us, for this family. Now you're telling me how to run
this
my business?
This isn't about your business, this is our life.
She's wonderful. It's right away when we just fell into it very easily. She had a natural, like, maternal energy with me.
You have to do what's right for you, not him, not me, not anyone. This is your life.
Britt Marling is a really talented actress and up-and-coming herself, and she had a Wall Street background before she got into the film industry, which also lent itself to really just fitting into this role.
You're fired, Ben.
You can't fire me.
Oh, I just did.
Who do you think asked me to make those changes?
You tell me. The moment I talked with Nick on Skype, I was just like, I love the way he sees the story. I love his passion and enthusiasm for making it. If I lie for you.
You didn't know about it. That's why I didn't tell you.
I'm the chief investment officer of this company. What do you think they're going to say at the deposition? She didn't know. They'll take away my brokerage license. Failure to supervise you. I was pretty much on board from that point. I was really excited.
All you said was you needed a ride. You didn't tell me you killed that girl.
Jimmy, I didn't.
I'm trying to put my life back together.
Nate Parker's one of the best young actors around in Hollywood right now, and we were just really lucky that he wanted to play Jimmy.
He's an original. His instincts, I think, are really terrific.
Earl said they offered me a deal. No charges at all. I walk away. He just wanted to know who I went to pick up.
The locations are a pretty pivotal additional character in the film.
We shot in the real locations, the real places that very wealthy people in New York go.
You can't really shoot a movie on finance that's not based in New York City.
Tell me! I can't! I lie! No, it's not me!
We're operating on a limited budget, and yet we have this grand feel that gives the realness and the texture is enveloping and brings you into the world as you take this character's journey with him.
This movie takes you on a good ride into worlds that you often don't get to see.
Something that I hoped we would get, and I think we're getting it.
You think money's gonna fix this?
What else is there?